Okay, to let everybody in on the latest project, I am doing an 8-piece dinner service for my son and daughter-in-law. I have done better at the plates. I've got these folded over actually at the moment. Let me see if I can balance the phone and show you those. Bear with me a second. So I've done the plates like this. I've used a method of slab rolling. And then what I'm doing, I'm just going to make the tea plates. So I thought I'd stop there and then let you see how I'm doing them. I've got 8 to make. I've got one made, but that was like a test piece. But I obviously I'm going to make another 8, so they're all the same, made the same way. So let's see how we go. Talk to me at night. Little bit of Fleetwood Mac. I'm obviously going to have to speed you all up because you're not allowed to listen to it, I don't think. But it's very cool to throw pots to. Alexa, pause. I've decided, so you know that it's too thick. So I want to just take that all back down again and roller it down to make it a bit thinner. When I did the big pots, the big plates, I knew that it was 3 pound of clay. So I didn't know what to use for this. So I've done 2 pound of clay, but that was going to be too heavy. So I'm just going to just flatten it out a bit more. And that will mean we can try again and see how thick that is. I'm going to try pound and a half on the next one when I flatten it by hand. So if we go back to just flattening this out, and then I'll speed you up again. Alexa, play. I just want to say thank you to everybody who watches what I do. I'm still sort of learning what people prefer to watch and what they don't want to watch, but I'm chuffed to bits. So I need to reinforce who I am. I'm Lois Hook Pottery, based in Northampton, England. And all I would say to you is if you like what I do, please remember to subscribe to my channel and then press the bell if you want to be alerted to when I post a new video. The aim is to carry on doing the videos. I love it. Got lots of ideas, hopefully if you want to follow what I do, then subscribe. So this clay is lava fleck. As we've said before, it's the one where, I'm saying this before, I know I'm repeating myself now, but it's the one where we get the grog clay. The one where we get the marks and the flecks. Because we want that to be part of the dinner service, the image of the lava fleck. So as you can probably tell, I haven't got a slab roller. So I'm getting this, so it's ready then to obviously put on the and I've got my 10 mil, and I know after looking at doing that last one that I clearly want less than the 10 mil that I just had, so I'll just dry my rolling pin and we're already under the 10 mil. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna we'll put it back on the wheel to flatten it using the roller. Put it there. Until we get something very similar to what we just had with the last one. Over. I don't know if a lot of you guys who have started to follow the channel actually know what I do. I know that when I watch people like John the Potter and all the others, they talk a lot about everything else they're involved with. Well, our business that we've been involved with since 1995 is reptiles. I have a reptile business in Northampton here. We actually have two shops. We have a shop that we've had all that time just for reptiles, and then 5 years ago we opened up one in a garden centre that has 85 fish systems, so that's really amazing. And then on top of that we have a website. We sell reptiles on not reptiles, we sell all the husbandry, all the items that they use to live. We sell all that stuff to the UK market, so we are very good at it. We've been doing it a long time, got a lot of people to help me now, and that is really why I've also got more time to do the pottery, which is nice. Right, so I'm now getting this, put a bit more water on, it's got to have something to float on. It sort of catches a bit at the beginning and you sort of have to just start it and it'll grab some of the clay. And as you can see, right, so what's happened there, I'm grabbing the clay too much, it's moved my bat off centre. Now, as you know, I'm using just this stick down method. And what it means, because I'm talking, I've got to just be a bit thoughtful. So I want to get this knot so it's not so thick. Just pushing down evenly. Again, sort of have a look and see whether I want it to dry so that they're not too heavy. But I also want them to be heavy enough that they've got character. Okay, so that'll do. So what we will do is we'll just clean that off the roller. I'm
just been watching John the Potter, who's gone to Matthew Kelly's house to do a wood firing. They're just putting the they just blocked up all the front and put the kiln on. I don't know how many people in the UK have the availability to do wood firing, because obviously we have more rules and restrictions with regard to the smoke and what we're allowed to burn. And of course it is burning hot, it's a different clay, it's burning up to cone 13, I think they were saying. And I know John has thrown some pieces to have a go in the kiln. Right, okay, so let me concentrate. I'm taking this to 8.5 inches, sorry, working back in inches for this first initially. And so what I'm doing is a very gentle line, because I know that'll be too much. My ruler, and that is just bigger, so I'm going to now take that down to there. It's not much of a change, but I want to double check, because now that I've got one done, I do want them to be as close as I can get. So now I'm going to just take this down to the bat, and I'm just going to put this underneath to lift that bit of clay. Take that off. That was 1.5 pounds of clay, so that was better. And that's what I'll sort of stick with. Just use my angle tool here to take the spare off. And then I want a bit of water underneath the piece, because what I'm actually gonna do is cut it away from underneath with having the water between me and my metal tool. There you go, so that's that done. Then I'm gonna just start to work up. Get a bit of water in the middle. Okay, so let's just have a look and see. I'm aiming for it to end up being 8 with 7.5 in the middle. So what I'm going to do now is, because I want to take the side rim smaller than the thickness of the clay, so I'm now going to push into it so it's slightly smaller using the chamois and getting it so I've got a nice rim. Okay, and then what we're doing, we'll measure that again and double check that is dead the same size as the other one. Just lent on it a bit hard, so I'll just neaten that up. And then what we're going to do is use the, firstly let's take all that excess water out, and then we'll put some pressure down on that so we're actually compressing the base. But also I'm going to take this at the side so it's got a little bit of a curve. So when I roll it over to got a little lumpy bumpy bit there, make sure I deal with that. Don't know what that is, just check what I've got going on there. God, a little lumpy bumpy bit. Something in the clay. Right, it's not very helpful. Let's get that a bit, give that another compression to get rid of that lumpy bumpy bit. Check my width. As I said, I'm going for 8. And then use my that's the trouble with me, I'm a bit of a mucky thrower. I never know where any of my kit is. So yeah, then come round underneath here, giving myself a curve underneath. Lovely. And then, yeah, compressing the base. There we go. So it's a totally different way of doing a plate. I know some of you will have watched me doing the plates the last time where I was making them and flattening out the base. I haven't tried that again, to be fair, and I will go back to that method, but I'm just very keen when I've been watching the videos. I just didn't want to put too much pressure on that base because I didn't want it to warp. I don't want to do all these plates for this and then find that the whole lot shift. So let's just get that. So that's in a perfect alignment for us. Okay, and then just... There we go. I'm not putting a squiggle down the middle on these ones. It's going to be all about the colour of the glaze. I've got some pots, I've done some little pots, then when I will be doing samples of colour that you will see the videos. I've got actually, I don't know how many loads made, because we want it to be green, a greenish colour. But I bought toasted sage to try and to do that with some layering. So that'll be quite good. So there's number two done.
I just want to explain here that what I do with every piece is weigh the clay out. In this case, as you know, I'm using 1.5 pounds of clay. This clay, when I get the bag, the whole bag has been cut and wedged when you layer the clay, and you keep cutting it and layering it, cutting it and layering it. And then what I'm doing, I'm going to do some wedging on this now, just to make sure that all the clay particles are all aligned and it's easy then to process and use. It also should get all the air bubbles out. This technique on this one is just what they call the goat's head one, I think, ram's head. But I do that a bit. Then what I'm doing is I'm going to then turn it on its end and flatten from that point.
If any of you were just noticing there, I wedged that into the spiral. These have already been cut wedged. I wedged that into the spiral, so the spiral is turning that way in the clay. And now I'm flattening it, so the spiral, you can still see some of the spiral, the spiral is that way. Now, I understand that clay particles move, but you quite often don't really see people following any format with the way the clay, you know, they roll the balls. I always seem to do it that way and have no issues. It would be good to know other people's thoughts on how they, where they want the clay to be, what their aim is when they're getting it ready to throw on the wheel. I know this is a bit different because clearly I'm flattening it. Okay, so we should have this. So you're looking down sort of in my eye line. I'm hoping my head's not going to be in the way. That's sort of fitting in there. See how that looks? That's okay. Oh, what I'll do is I will just, sorry about that, I'll come to the side here so you can see what I'm doing. I'm sort of doing this bit here because I know now what sort of thickness I'm thinking. Okay, and then I can just give it a quick, now we have moved it a bit, so I should just put it back into centre. There we go. Okay, get the rolling pin. Can feel it catch quite quickly. Let's have a look and see whether that looks about the right thickness, which I think it does. Give it a little bit more. Okay. Clean it off the rolling pin. Okay, and then my thing is set to 8.5 inches. I know you'll all be saying, why are you doing it in inches? Well, just because I can, I suppose. Do it very thinly so that I can check to see where I am with the, so I'm quite a way too big there, I've got to come in. So if I just do another, in a bit. Just double check where I'm at. Yep, to cut that then. So I've clearly still got too much clay in a pound and a half, but that's fine. Just give this a... Always got to be careful when you get to the middle. I have a terrible habit when I get to the middle of cutting in. So, but we all know we want to make sure that we've compressed the base so we don't have any cracking. I've never ever had a pot crack yet, ever. I think I do, apart from that one time when I'd put wet clay in, I do make sure that everything is really dry. So then what I'm doing is bringing water in to feed round the outside while I use the metal saw to get underneath, which it now is, and then wetting up the top again so that my hand can be there when I'm pulling up the side. Bring the side up. Have a little look and check that I'm sort of bringing the side up so that that's going to sit eight or just under, which it does. Grab my my edging thing and then give myself a proper so now I just keep double checking as I start finishing it off. That's the right distance. I don't know if you can see that. So that is saying just under the eight. It's about just a couple of marks under. Then I'm going to do the side. So it's lifted. Quite nice. Okay, we're going to do the inside of here. Let's dry it and then compress it. The thing to make sure everything is now not jumbling about. Check that I've got what I have. So that looks like it's gone more square than the others, so that's what I've got to be careful of, though I think that they probably all ended up a little bit more squarer than the dinner plates. Make sure that that's good. Okay, and then dry my wheel off, which is what I forgot to do the last time. That's another one done.
I want to thank one of my guys that has been chatting to me after seeing one of my videos and watching me on Instagram for suggesting that when you flatten out the base on a plate, you can use the rolling pin. I had seen it on a video a long time ago, but this is the first time I've tried that technique. And to be fair, it seems to work really, really well. I'm really sorry about this. The bat ran out. My bat's run out. And if you have a look at that now, it's oscillating terribly. So it looks so off center. But of course, the main part of the clay isn't off center. So that's absolutely fine. But it's been an absolute joy to have you with me on this journey. That I'm investigating how to fire the plates now, because clearly there's a lot of discussion about you can stack them on their end, you can put them on top of each other. I was looking at how to do the bowls, and I've got silica sand, no, normal sand, actually play sand ordered, because I've seen when you have lots of bowls, you can actually stack some sand in there, and that means it's sitting on the sand instead of sitting on the rim. So that's sort of the next video I'm going to be doing. Speak to you soon. Thanks, guys.